This event is being streamed live on YouTube on Fina Channel. So in a moment, I will introduce you to our celebrity commentators.
You join us for the free routine final for the soloists. And the start sheet on your screen at the moment. It's the final day's coverage of the FINA 17th World Junior Championships in artistic swimming. Shortly be starting with the countdown before the day's activities commence. Well, if you've been watching previously, you'll know that we're in Quebec City, declared a World Heritage Site by UNESCO in 1985, known as the Historic District of Old Quebec. This wonderful pool is at the University of Laval, superb facilities for this Junior World Championships as we greet the 12 finalists. Slovakia will be swimming first, followed by Kazakhstan, Mexico, they've been drawn to swim third, followed by Switzerland, and then Great Britain. Germany. Canada, bound to get a good reception here. France. Japan, favourites after the preliminary rounds. Spain. Greece. And then the final competitor will be from Italy. So it's all about the solo free finals today. And once again, I'm joined by Claudia Holzner, Olympian and 3 times Pan American Games gold medalist. So 3 panels of judges. What will those judges be looking for? What's the main thing when it comes to solo free?
So free is quite different from technical programs. And what we'll be seeing today is our judges are going to be focusing on the execution of the routines. So really watching that excellence level, as well as the synchronization. And with a solo, you can be synchronized with the music. So that's what they'll be looking for today. As well as an artistic impression panel, which will include the choreography, the musical impression, and the manner of presentation. And finally, and most importantly in my personal opinion, the difficulty score. So that's one where the athletes will really show their technical skills.
So the 3 panels of judges, the routines, 2.5 minutes long. And I guess, Claudia, what they need to do is pack as much into that 2.5 minutes to really show their strengths. Because it's not long, is it? But they will be exhausted by the end of the performance.
They will be, and they'll really want to be able to show how well they can do this program. They've been training it for a long time, and this is their final shot to show what they've got.
So the judges just being introduced in the background. As Claudia mentioned, 3 panels. Slightly higher percentage on the artistic compared with the technical program. So 40% of the overall score is artistic, 30% on execution and difficulty. When they walk out onto the poolside, they have a maximum of 30 seconds. Then they have to be ready and then you'll hear a whistle. Once the whistle has gone, music starts, they have 10 seconds to enter the pool. Jacqueline Simoneau, double Olympian.
And my duet partner, nice
of course,
to see her.
Yes. Yes, you swam together at the Tokyo Olympics last year, didn't you?
Yeah.
And what a fabulous job you both did.
It was a great journey, for sure.
So the pool is around about 25 metres and they have to cover that down the length, probably about 3 laps of the pool and across the width as well, because the judges are positioned either side of the pool. And Claudia, how important is it that they impress the judges very quickly?
It's so incredibly important. And with that propulsion of movement in that pool, you're really showing how powerful you are and how much strength you have in the water.
So pool coverage, an important part of a solo. So even when they're in their verticals, and they're doing their hybrids, most of the time they're still traveling, aren't they?
Exactly. They will never be on the spot unless they're spinning up and down.
So, first to swim, the soloist from Slovakia, Kára Dickey. She was inspired by the movie Bohemian Rhapsody. This is her interpretation, music, Freddie Mercury and Queen.
Solos, we're going to see a lot of expression of the body, so making sure we're using all of those muscles in a 3D form. And she is doing an excellent job here. Beautiful transition there, straight up into a vertical spin, slight deviation on the body alignment. Strong spin down there into a beautiful transition. Really using that music to create a story. Much explosive power in this routine with those thrust movements up above the water. Such an emotional solo here from Slovakia. Excellent work.
Yeah, you mentioned about telling a story, and it's so important for soloists to really live the music, isn't it? How important and how much does it help the choreography if you do have a theme to follow?
I think it's incredibly important. It's always a little bit difficult, you know, you're the only person in the water during a solo, so you have to tell the story. You don't have anybody around you that can help. So this is where, as you'll see on your screen right now, they're showing their emotions as much as possible here.
And how long would it take to develop a solo like this?
You know, it can range from anywhere between creating it over a week and then training it over a full year, maybe a couple of months, maybe even 2 years. So for these soloists, they're definitely trying to master their program as best they can.
And when you say training it, obviously that's sort of really focusing on the execution, but I guess that's lots of changes to the choreography made along the way as the athlete improves. You can fit in extra bits, can't you?
Exactly. Well, there's typically a first draft, a second draft, a third draft.
25th draft, 26th yeah. draft, 20, yeah.
Potentially, yeah.
So her score, 77.333. Slightly less than she scored in the preliminary rounds. The scores don't carry through at all after the preliminaries. That was purely to see who qualified in the top 12 for this final. And then in the draw, the ones that qualified in the top six, they swim towards the end of this draw, don't they?
Exactly. So we'll see the top six swimmers really showing it at the very final six draw.
Second to swim from Kazakhstan, Karina Magdropova, qualified in eighth place. Her music, Cleopatra, Peter Gabriel. She loves to express the music.
Look at that height, really showing off that flexibility in that first lift. Straight into some sustained height here and a beautiful body alignment. Right down to the end. Excellent work. Transition there, really using her body to move with the water. Incredible height and that explosive thrust. Really passionate swim here from Kazakhstan. Especially that first vertical, the control there, oh, beautiful.
It really was, and as you were talking about it, I was looking at some of the arm movements underneath the water, the sculling action underneath. And what amazes me is how high they stay when they've got arms above their head. In my day, you know, we had sport scull, which we still use in artistic swimming a lot, but I've never been able to master the arm above the head and still keeping the height. It's really, really hard, isn't it?
It is really difficult. And imagine trying to lift weights above your head and waving them back and forth. You're lifting a whole person out of the water. So there's a lot of different techniques nowadays where you use one arm down, one arm up. Things have changed so dramatically.
They have. And it's so impressive, especially when the legs are so solid above the surface of the water that you can't see them like slightly wobbling from the movement of the arms from underneath the water.
Exactly. Well, that takes so much core strength and back strength to just be able to hold that solid. Yeah, she did a great job there.
She did that really well, I thought.
Yes.
So her score was 81.033 in prelims, 80.9667. So very close. So puts her in first place. with 10 more to swim. Soloist from Mexico, Jimena Ortiz Montano, qualified seventh, just slightly ahead of the swimmer from Kazakhstan. Her music, La Femme, the empowerment of women.
Slight deviation on the line there, but beautiful spin action after that thrust. That's going to add to her difficulty score. And the wow, flexibility split thrust there, showing off the back straps of her swimsuit. Incredibly difficult move here, staying in that arch position as she spins and right into a figure. Beautiful. Sustained off-angle spin. That is difficult. Slight dip there in the body alignment on that second spin. But she's still going. Excellent work from Mexico. Such a strong swim from Mexico. I have never seen that many off angles in one solo routine. So much strength and so much explosive power into those thrusts.
She really executed them so well. I thought that one, the first off angle, the main one, was just incredible.
Incredible, and she sustained it for so long. It's incredibly difficult to do.
And she's only 16, so she is one of the younger ones in this competition. The age group is from 15 up to a maximum of 18. So she has a very bright future ahead of her in the sport, I'm absolutely sure. The Pan Am Junior Championships, she took a gold and a silver medal in that. Scored 81 in the preliminaries. I'm sure the judges will recognize the difficulty in that performance.
I'm sure they will. She did not let us miss it, that's for sure.
And her feet extension
was right until the end.
Yeah. And we'll talk about that a little bit later, because there are special exercises and equipment you can use to help that, aren't there? .81.766, and they did indeed recognize that, and that has put her ahead of the soloist from Kazakhstan. quite an improvement on her score from the preliminary rounds. Congratulations. And for to swim from Switzerland, Alice Ponsar, 18 years of age, the flight of a butterfly.
Starting off with those butterfly movements, a really creative way to enter into those figures, and beautiful height there in that thrust. Coming from an arch into a vertical, your arms have to be in the right place at the right time, so she did that excellently. Show of that off angle into a slight dip there for the body alignment. You want to have those spins nice and straight down to the bottom of the pool. Creativity here to have the legs and hands up at the same time. Beautiful swim here from Switzerland. Such creative transitions, and as I said earlier, those hands out and feet out at the same time, that's so difficult to do.
She had beautiful posture in the water, didn't she? And
beautiful.
Lovely graceful arms as well for the butterfly theme. And her shoulder flexibility really shone through, which all parts of their body have to be so flexible in this sport, don't they?
So incredibly flexible, not just splits, but in all aspects so that they can perform at their best and also stay really healthy too.
Yes, important. We were talking about the flexibility in the feet earlier. What tips would you give for somebody that wants to improve on that?
Well, we do a lot of exercises with TheraBands actually. So we use that around our toes and we exercise our feet every single morning. And there's a lot of ballet movements in there as well.
Good advice. 78.1333. Third place for Alice Ponsar from Switzerland.
Number one.
from Great Britain. Next to swim, we have Robin Swatman. The music, Feeling Good, the feeling of being free.
Showing incredible explosive height into that body boost. And yet again with those straps out of the water. Incredibly difficult move there in that arch position. Takes so much control. Tension in these movements, arms and legs. It's beautiful to see. Aha, yes, an incredible spin there. Great body alignment. Really using those arm movements to portray the music as best as possible. She's really acting it out and shining here. Excellent work. Excellent swim from Great Britain. So much intention, so much control, and you can just tell that she went out there ready to go.
I think that was one of the best I've seen her swim, and her coach there, Katie Clark, looked very happy with the performance as well. Works very closely with Amy Baker back home as well as her club coach. As a lot of these swimmers do have two coaches, don't they? But that music really suited her, didn't it?
No, it really did. And just being able to see how she finishes her movements into the tips of her fingers and all the way through to her toes, you can tell she was just ready to perform for us today.
And she's really improving on her explosive power. There was a lot of energy in that.
A lot. And it takes so much energy in general just to finish a routine, but to be able to go out with a bang, start from the very first body boost that she had all the way into the last position. She did a fantastic job.
Well, she's had a busy year because she's been competing as a senior as well as a junior, as a lot of these juniors do actually. So they'll be looking forward to a nice rest, I think, after this World Juniors. is her score. That's a third place at the moment. So she will be analysing that, I have no doubt, with her coaches, and look forward to seeing her continue to progress. Swim, Clara Bleyer from Germany. Her music is Ball by Igor Kornilik.
So much propulsion already in this routine. Good start, big figure here, and we're still going. Lots of sustained height into those spins, showing how strong she is. Good off angle movement there. Good explosive thrust into that spin. Adding so much difficulty here. Beautiful swim from Germany. Such a difficult routine and executed so well.
So much power in the performance. And the musicality, particularly on, there was one hybrid that I really liked and thought went very well with the music, which was the off angle one.
Yeah.
I don't know if we'll get a chance to see it again, but it was great. And very solid on the vertical lines, wasn't she? Very, very steady.
Very steady, and she started off that routine with such a long first hybrid, almost looking like she was going to come out and then going right back into it.
And then after a long hybrid like that, it's so important to have very quick recovery time, because you can't let it affect the rest of the performance. You need to keep your energy going, don't you?
Exactly, and you're holding your breath the whole time, so your heart rate is just pounding.
You should know. Coached by Stella Makhavidova. She's been doing the choreography for about a year now. Scored 80.6 in preliminaries. So, quite a big improvement on her preliminary swim. So that puts her second. Six more to swim. Great result for her, and you can see just how delighted they both are. As we move into the second half of the draw, and first to swim within that is Canada, Audrey Lamotte. Her music, Stardust. The 17-year-old. Her theme is Hungarian spirit.
Setting up for a beautiful thrust with her spins. Into another one. A confident start here. really dynamic split rocket. Really shining here as she sees the audience, all of her teammates in the crowd. Excellent execution of that spin and lots of sustained height there. Beautiful. Off angle movement there, just a tad shaky. But really going for it in the technical skills, adding to the difficulty of this routine. Off angle movements into that thrust. And a solid finish here by Canada. Excellent swim, such a confident swim with so much energy. And she really packs in those technical elements, adding to that difficulty score.
That was superb. The music's so, so fast, but she really kept up the speed of movement throughout.
Exactly. She works so well in adding those skills, both in arms and in legs. So those tiny, tiny movements, making sure to finish those movements all the way with her fingers and toes.
And she's another one that's had a very busy year competing as a senior as well. But she has true talent. Choreography by Karen Dore. Coached by Yin Lin Hu. She scored 83.867, a fabulous score, was lying in fifth place after the preliminaries. I don't think she could have done that much better, really.
I don't think so. She has trained so hard and she has so much more experience now going with that senior level and senior team into that World Championships. This is just a great way to finish it for her.
An improvement on her prelim score and thoroughly deserved. That's a terrific score for her.
Terrific.
Clearly putting her in first place.
Excellent, excellent work. She must be so happy.
It's a responsibility, isn't it, swimming in front of a home crowd. It's great because you have the support, but it is extra, nerves, I think,
come into it. There's a little bit more pressure, right?
Yeah.
Definitely more exciting, but she loves representing Canada, so I'm sure she enjoyed every minute of that swim.
Now from France, to swim, Lelis Alves. This is the world of dolls and automation. Two pieces of music to express the metamorphosis of a pin-up doll and an automated one.
Great dynamic height into that first thrust. Thank you. Beautiful. Excellent control into that spin after the thrust. Incredibly hard to do, especially after an arch position. Good spin. Beautiful body alignment there. You can really see her theme coming through here. So creative. Good work. Slight dip there in the spin. Wow, nice sustained height. And those small movements takes a lot of muscle. Excellent solidity in that top leg there. Beautiful swim from France. Such original choreography, really portraying that theme.
I always find that with the French routines. They're so creative. The construction of their routines is so, so clever, aren't they? And that was so charismatic throughout. Showed a lot of personality.
Even into the legs.
Yes, yes.
Which is hard to do.
Very hard to do. The contours that she gets, the angles are just absolutely beautiful. And really clear definition of what she's trying to achieve. She swam at the European Youth Championships earlier this year and actually did incredibly well, winning first in figure solo and duet. And I think she won the solo by nearly 6 points, something like that, a long way ahead. So a huge, huge talent. A 0.7 increase over her preliminary score. That's first place. Stunning performance. Now the world youth champion, the junior world champion in the technical solo. This is Mohiga from Japan. The theme, Strange Story.
Excellent dynamic thrust there. Into those off angle movements. Really adding the artistry into those feet. Wow, incredible transition. Such intricate movements here. Excellent spin, trying to stay above the knee as long as possible, and she does it. with so much speed. They're really using the music, adding to that artistic impression. Such a fun way to end. Excellent performance by Japan. So much speed into the movement. You really see her elbows and her knees lock right in when she's straightening her legs and arms.
I think it's always a good sign of a very good solo and great choreography. When it's quite surprised to have finished, it seemed really, really quick.
It did. It went by so fast. And I think, too, with how intricate her movements was, she really used the ending of her fingers and just made that theme so visual for us.
It was very, very polished indeed from somebody so young as well. Very intense, dynamic. The interpretation to the music was incredible, I thought. So much artistry. What a year she's had, swimming at the World Youth Championships, the World Junior Championships, and the World Senior Championships. She must be absolutely exhausted, but never shows it at all in her performance. 89.7667, getting so, so close to scores in the 90s. Unbelievably good. And if she does go on to win the gold, and it looks like she could well do with a score like that, it will mean that Japan have won the solo world champion in seniors, youth, and juniors as well. What a year they've had. Soloist from Spain, Marina Garcia Polo. And she will be doing a typical Spanish dance.
Into that first thrust. Beautiful hybrid there, straight into that solid vertical, showing how much control she has. Slight fall in the body alignment there as she finished that spin. Good spin there. adding to her difficulty score. Great swim from Spain. That was executed so well, showing so many off-angle movements into those solid, stopped vertical positions.
And you can really see they're born with this, they grow up with this, all the Spanish dancing, the movements. She lives in Andalusia, and she loves the traditional music, and you can really see it through to the fingertips, can't you? And the posture in the water shines through.
Exactly, almost like it was built for her, which it was. Yeah.
She qualified in a second place, just missed out on a medal in the technical event, so she will be very hopeful of getting on the podium in the free solo. It'll be interesting to see on these scores next year with the judging looking like it's changing once it's been ratified. At the moment, the scores are 1.1, 0.2, 0.3, and then it's going to go to 0.25, 0.5, isn't it? So it'll be interesting to see how that affects the scores.
Yeah, I think it's going to make it a little bit more simple, a little bit easier to see, and maybe potentially easier to judge because there's not that big of a difference.
Wow, 87.600. That's a 1.2 increase over her preliminary score. Really, really good job. So 11th to swim from Greece, Eleni Frakaki. Her first year as a soloist. And this is her love story.
Showing her height and flexibility here. Excellent job there. And into that off angle spin up. So well executed. Feeling the emotion of this love story. Oh, the artistry here. Thrusting back to back. That is hard to do. Well executed there. Such elegant arm movements. adding to that artistic impression. Just a fantastic swim here from Greece. So emotional. You can feel the pain in this love story.
It was enchanting, wasn't it? She really told the story. It was beautiful.
So beautiful.
I love her arm movements. The movements really start from the shoulder, don't they, and go all the way down to the fingertips. Absolutely beautiful. She finished fifth at the European Junior Championships earlier this year. Qualified for this final in a sixth place. The choreography was done by Natalia Chinetska, coached here by Anastasia Gutseva and Barbara Lithofiotti. She's doing an incredible job considering it's her first year as a soloist.
It's incredible. Her arm movements are so mature already. It's exciting to see where the future is going to go.
So that's fourth place for her. That's a fabulous score. Puts her just ahead of the Canadian. Congratulations on a magnificent swim. Getting so much support from her teammates. Last to swim from Italy, Susanna Pedotti took the silver in the tech solo. Qualified in third place. Can she do enough to get on the podium again in the solo free?
To that vertical. Beautiful spin here. Excellent execution of that spin after the thrust. And a beautiful sustained vertical into that spin. Really showing off her control here. Yeah. variation in the body alignment there. But overall, an incredibly emotional swim here from Italy. Fantastic work.
So serene. I've watched her quite a bit this year because they have the European Senior Championships in Rome, and they use the opportunity to have pre-swimmers, and the junior team are always the pre-swimmers. And every time I saw her, I was just incredibly impressed. So to get on the podium, look at that height and the control that she had there was just amazing. So to get on the podium, she needs a score of more than 85.800. So currently first is Japan, then Spain, then France, then Greece, then Canada. Susanna Padotti from Italy had to wait till the very, very end for her performance, so she will know her final placing the minute the scores go up. She's done it. A score of 86.800. She is going to add yet another medal to her collection, and it will be a bronze to add to the silver she got in the technical solo. I'm not sure if she's aware. There wasn't much of a reaction, was there?
No, not yet. Maybe with the coaches.
Yeah. Choreography by Stefania Speroni, coached by Benedetta Parisella, Elisa Plaisant and Rosanna Rocchi. Great job that they've done with her. So we'll await the final confirmation of the scores. But what a final it's been. Get a chance to see some of the highlights from the solo free final. Once we've had a chance to see the final rankings, we will then have a break. We'll be back at about 1 o'clock for the free team final, just before 1 o'clock, about 10 minutes before. That's Quebec time, of course. And then that will be followed by a gala at about 3 o'clock this afternoon. The amplitude they get on these hybrids, amazing. Get higher and higher every year as techniques continue to improve. Hopefully we will have the final rankings, but certainly from my calculations, Japan, the gold, Spain, the silver, Italy, the bronze, and we just have the confirmation here. Yep, indeed. Japan, Spain, Italy, followed by France, Greece, Canada. very, very close between Greece and Canada there. Mexico, Germany, close between them as well. Kazakhstan, Great Britain, Switzerland, Slovakia. A lot of the scores are pretty close, aren't they?
Really close.
It was a great final.
It was. Everybody came and showed their best routines. A lot of height and execution and just so much risk in those off-angle movements.
Well, we were both very impressed indeed. But from Claudia and myself, Andrea Holland, it's goodbye for now.